Ever pondered why the Israel-Palestine conflict seems to be an endless cycle of tension and strife? Let's journey back to the aftermath of World War I. The British set foot in Palestine, declaring it a national home for Jewish people. Over the next two decades, a wave of over 100,000 Jews found their way to Palestine. But with the British withdrawal in 1948, an era of escalating tension ensued, paving the way for the Arab-Israeli War. A land divided and disputed, left in the hands of two populations with deep-rooted historical claims. But the consequences of this conflict extend far beyond the borders of these two nations. It seeps into the minds and hearts of the youngest, most innocent victims, the children. In Gaza, the trauma is almost universal. Nearly every child there carries the weight of conflict-related distress. Even in Israeli communities, children living within range of rockets fired from Gaza grapple with high levels of stress and anxiety. This isn't just a local issue, though. The international community is deeply entangled in these threads of conflict. Take China, for example. Its economic interests in the Middle East and ties with Iran, a known supporter of Hamas, place it in a precarious position. It walks a tightrope of diplomacy, urging for calm and restraint, yet stopping short of condemning any one side. This careful dance isn't just about political correctness. It's about safeguarding economic interests, maintaining relations, and preventing the conflict from disrupting regional stability. So you see, this isn't just a regional conflict, it's a global echo, a ripple effect that touches lives far and wide. A regional conflict with a global echo, a ripple effect that touches lives far and wide. So what fuels this persistent conflict? The roots trace back to the aftermath of World War I, when British occupation declared Palestine a national home for Jewish people. This led to an influx of Jewish immigrants, escalating tensions that erupted into the Arab-Israeli War post the British withdrawal in 1948. The conflict has left deep scars on both sides, particularly on the children of Gaza, with an alarming 91% suffering from conflict-related trauma. It's a cycle of violence that continues to reopen old wounds. Internationally, it's a geopolitical chessboard with nations like China playing a cautious game, balancing its historical support for Palestine against its economic interests in the Middle East. In the end, it's a tale of two peoples, two narratives, and a land that both call home.